Taking sleeping pills on a regular basis is associated with an increased risk of death and cancer. That's according to a study published in the online journal BMJ Open. It's authored by local researcher Dr. Daniel Kripke. Some of the findings are alarming. Let's take a look. Patients using hypnotics, or in other words, sleeping pills, had an increased risk of death. Fewer than 18 hypnotic doses per year increased mortality. Overall, cancer increased by 35% among those prescribed high doses. Now, joining me to talk about these findings is Scripps researcher Dr. Daniel Kripke. Thank you for being here.
Oh, thank you. I'm glad to be here.
So tell us about how you went about this research.
And this study was done with the help of electronic medical records of a big system in northeastern U.S. And we found in a five-year period over 10,000 patients who had been prescribed sleeping pills. And then we matched them with over 20,000 controls who had never been prescribed a sleeping pill. And we matched them for age and for their sex and for whether or not they smoked. And then statistically, we matched them for health for 12 different kinds of diagnoses. So it's what we call a matched cohort study.
So for people who might say, okay, well, the people who were taking sleeping pills, maybe they just were in poor health to begin with, which is why they were taking sleeping pills. Your study accounted for that.
It's true that the people taking sleeping pills were in somewhat poorer health than those not getting those prescriptions, but not four times worse. And we did control for that statistically to the extent we were able. And let me say the control made very little difference. So even though the control is imperfect, if the amount of control we did made so little difference, I think more control wouldn't make much difference.
Yes, the drugs you looked at are I want to say, fairly common. I mean, we know these names, Ambien, Lunesta, even Benadryl. Benadryl, an antihistamine, was on this list. So what is it about these drugs? Is there a common thing that is sort of increasing your risk?
Well, we studied these because they were the ones commonly used in this health system. And I didn't necessarily expect Benadryl or Ambien to show a risk, and certainly I was surprised by what we found. Yes, I was shocked. I'm still shocked at the size of this risk.
Now, I want to split this up into two categories because it's also increased risk of death. Now, was your study able to determine the cause of death? Just, I mean, months past, KPBS reported that one of the leading causes of accidental death is due to prescription drug overdose. We've had some high-profile cases in the media lately about this. How do we know that people aren't dying because they're taking sleeping pills and they're drinking and they're taking something else?
Well, we know they are. That's one of the causes. And we know that they tend to find a lot of sleeping pills in the blood of people who've had automobile accidents, people who have falls, people who die at night. So these are probably some of the causes.
So it's not necessarily what's in the sleeping pill causing you to die. It's the fact that it puts you in a certain state of mind.
The sleeping pills, they stop our brain cells from working, and that's not good for you. In the highest doses, barbiturates are used to execute prisoners because they stop breathing. In lower doses, when mixed with alcohol and other things, all of these drugs can stop breathing or make sleep apnea worse. And that's probably one of the mechanisms, not the only one. They cause depression, and people taking sleeping pills have a high suicide rate. They cause infections. And they cause cancer.
We don't have a lot of time left. This is work you've been doing for a very long time. You told me earlier back in the 70s is when you first discovered that sleeping pills were probably not very good for you. You know, is this, some people might argue that maybe this has been a long time sort of mission to sort of find, you know, for you to kind of come to this conclusion.
Well, we saw evidence earlier. This is the strongest evidence. And this is the first evidence to name the particular pills. But there are 18 different studies done mainly by other people in other countries that show the same association of sleeping pills with mortality. It's not just my study. The only thing about this study that's special is it names the pills, it shows the dose response, and it was better controlled for confusing factors than the other studies.
And I want to tell the people at home that we have the list of those drugs, more on this study, more information on our website, kpbs.org. Dr. Daniel Kripke, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.